Hi everybody, this is just a quick note before you listen to the episode. I don't like doing these notes because I do think it messes with the flow, but it's important that I just point a couple of things out. First things first, the sound quality at the beginning is a wee bit dodgy because the mic I'm using is actually starting to fail on me. I need to take it back, so apologies for the sound at the beginning, and you'll hear some sound through it, so apologies for that, guys. Secondly, I've got a bit of a cold going on at the moment, so I apologise for the sound of my voice. I'm a bit bunged up. And thirdly, the podcast itself was done very quickly, straight after the Man City game. It's really me just getting my emotions and my feelings off my chest, how I feel about a result, how I feel about people that have been giving us a hard time. It is a bit of a rant. It's a bit of a kind of two fingers up at everybody who's been criticising the club, because I do feel strongly about Celtic, and it was a bit of a kind of, get things off your chest episode. Hopefully you enjoy it. I do have a go at a few people, but hey, that's the way it goes when you love the club and people are trying to bring down the very thing that you love. So I'll let you listen to it. Hopefully you enjoy it, guys, and I'll speak to you soon. Hail, hail. Hi everybody, welcome to the beginning of episode 6. This is, I hadn't planned on doing an episode, but I'm going to do it because I've just finished watching one of the greatest games I've seen at Celtic Park. We didn't win the game, but as far as I'm concerned, what we just saw tonight or this morning for me, because I'm based in New Zealand, so I had to watch it at 7 o'clock this morning on one of the worst streams I've ever managed to get hold of. Eventually I got a good stream, so I watched it, and I've watched all the highlights since and stuff, but what we witnessed is just everything that I ever want to see from my club, everything that I ever think about when I think about being from Glasgow, when I think about being from Scotland, when I think about being a Celtic supporter. I think about just having fight, having determination, and being brave, and not being intimidated, and being honest, and just show the world that it doesn't matter where you come from, it doesn't matter how people have might talk about you, or how your reputation might be with others, or what's happened to you in the past. You shake all that off, and you go forward, and you fight, you move on. And you show people what you're worth, and you show people that you're strong and that you're true to heart. And that's what Celtic did tonight. They showed that they're brave, they showed that they can play, and they showed that they're not intimidated. Now, I did a podcast after the Barcelona game where I highlighted the value of Barcelona's team, and I emphasised the huge gulf and finances and resources that these big clubs have. And you know, that still stands true. You know, we UEFA put us in a position as a club where we are forced to live off scraps, and then they put massive hurdles in front of us to stop us getting into this private country club where these, you know, super clubs swan about with, you know, multi-million dollar players, and they've all got perfect training grounds, and they've got perfect setups, and you know, and it's like every now and again they let a poor person in from the street to eat at the side of the restaurant. You know, we're all sitting there with our noses pressed up against the glasses, starving, and then they'll invite someone in to show everybody how generous they all are. Oh, look at us, we're great, look, we let the little people in now and again. And that's the society that we live in, guys. We live in a society, generally, where it's all about the elite, it's all about the wealthy, it's all about the rich. I'm not going to get political on this podcast. I have very defined political beliefs that are probably well in line with most of Celtic support. But I stand for the little guy, and that's what Celtic did tonight. That's what Celtic did tonight. They didn't just fight for Celtic fans. They didn't just fight for Glasgow. They showed the rest of football that it doesn't matter where you come from, and it doesn't matter what other people might think of you. You could still go toe-to-toe with the big boys and send them home with a few black eyes, more than a few black eyes. We had them on the ropes. We could have won that game now. Yeah, in the end, we got tired, but that's because I mean, I cannot name a single Celtic player, not one Celtic player that I would say he had a bad game or he didn't give us all. I don't know what Brendan Rodgers did at before kickoff, and I don't know what he did at halftime, but as far as I can see, he instilled the spirit of the club, the very essence of our club, in each and every one of those players. And I tell you, nights like tonight, or days like today, wherever you are in the world, whoever you are, you watch that, if it doesn't fill your heart up with pride, and bring a tear to your eye for being a Celtic supporter, not even being from Scotland, it doesn't matter where you're from, it's about what's inside your heart. And those players demonstrated clearly what it means to stand up for the little guy, to stand up for those who don't have what others have. And we don't have what others have. We don't have their money. We don't have their super status. We don't have their EPL, cream of the crop Champions League cash. But you know what? We don't care. And we don't care that we get pumped off Barcelona 7-0. I said at the end of my podcast, after we lost that game 7-0, we don't care. That was the whole, the whole thinking behind that episode was that, okay, so we took a hiding. It happens. We don't care. We're going to put it behind us and move on. And I said, if we can give a good account of ourselves and give teams at Parkhead a black eye, that's the best you can hope for. Okay, we didn't win the game, and when I watched that game, I was hoping that we'd get a late winner. You know, the old Scott McDonald last minute, or a free kick outside the box and gets whipped in by Griffiths. I'm finding it difficult to go. I watched the whole game, and I'm finding it difficult to go man by man, because every single player was outstanding. Every single one. And also, please excuse me, guys, I've got a bit of a head cold. It's going through the family. I've cut it off the wee one. She's got a dose. She's giving it to me and the missus. So if I sound like I've got a clothes peg over my nose. It's a total head cold, so I'm suffering a wee bit. But it was just incredible. I'm so homesick after watching that. I wish I was back in Glasgow. I watch games like that, and you do get emotional being away from home, because you want to be there. Even if you're not at the game, you want to be in and around the stadium, or you want to be in a good Celtic pub, because it's just the very essence of who we are, that type of fighting spirit. Get it up, yous. You might have this reputation, but we don't care. We don't care, because you're in Glasgow now. So be prepared to fight and treat us with respect. And there's so many pundits and so many reporters and so many ex-footballers and so many people in the world that can't wait to bring us down and just rub our noses in it if we do get a bad result, and they make the most of it. And it's nights like tonight where we can stand up and hold our heads up and say, we went with the very, very best, the richest, one of the richest teams in the world, from the richest league in the world, the top, top teams with some of the best players. And they struggled. They struggled. You've got young Kieran Tierney. It was outstanding, man. I mean, I knew he was going to score on that left side. You could see the space he had, and I thought, he's just going to drive a goal, and he did. He hit a beauty. And yeah, it came off Sterling, but he hit it so well that Sterling didn't have that much time to react to it. He just lashed his leg out and it went in. Even if it had gone to the keeper, it could have gone in. And just brilliant. Kieran Tierney was amazing. Scott Brown was brilliant. He really was. He fought in that midfield and was just outstanding. Dembele, I put a tweet out to 90 Minutes Cynic. I don't think they go. I think I did it too late. It was on the for the questions. And they said, send us questions. And I said, if Dembele continues his form, especially in Europe, how long are we going to hold on to him? And I see after tonight, and honestly, he's going to score more in Europe, guys, and he's going to keep on scoring for us. I'm worried that somebody's going to come in for him. And I hope his head doesn't get turned, because we need to keep him for another two or three seasons. That boy's only going to go on and do great things for us. He's got so much skill in many different areas as a forward player. And I've watched, as I said, I've been watching football a long time, and you see guys who move like that, who can control the ball at that, and who make runs the way he makes runs. We've really got a brilliant player in our hands in Moussa Dembele. The guy is phenomenal. Can't believe he's only 19, just turned 20. He's a beast, an absolute beast. Who else played well tonight? I mean, you go through them all. Gordon, brilliant saves at the end. And for me, Gordon stays in goals. I said to myself before the game, and I listened to a lot of stuff before the game, I was listening to a lot of other, like, just reports, podcasts, and everything else as I do, and I was thinking, right, I was thinking of doing a podcast before the game, but there was no point because it was too soon, and I was going to wait till after the game. But I thought, what would my prediction be? And my head, my heart was like, we can win this 3-2 with a late winner. And then my head was like, it's Man City and they're flying, we'll probably lose like 3-1 or 3-0. And I thought, you know what, the compromise is in the middle. I bet it's going to be 2-2 or 3-3. And that's what I settled on. I thought, right, I could put that out as a prediction. I might tweet it out or whatever. And that's what happened. It was 3-3. Now, my predictions are usually terrible. But yeah, 3-3. And that, I think if someone had offered any of us a 3-3 score at home against Man City, we'd all have taken it, you know. And what a brilliant game. What we showed that, I think of all the Champions League games played tonight, everybody would want to see ours. And I tried to catch it on it. Now, it's very difficult for me to watch the games out here. It's not on terrestrial TV. I can't afford Celtic TV. I have to catch it somehow. So, yeah, the inverted commas, streams that I used were very poor, and it was difficult to catch a good one. And I think it's because so many people were just using these different services. A lot of people were watching that game, and that, you know, that's just brilliant news for us, because again, it goes and shows the world and Europe and everybody else that we're a European side. And whether we're playing in the Champions League or whether we're playing in the Europa League, you know, we deserve to be there with the very best, as do other teams. As do other teams who don't come from big countries, who don't come from the wealthiest nations, you know. You know, when you've got this amount of money being pumped into like a very small percentage of clubs around the world, you're in danger of just completely ruining the competition, and it will tarnish the history of the elite European competition. It should be open to more teams, and it shouldn't be difficult. Shouldn't be difficult for teams from smaller nations to get in. Why do we have to go through three qualifying rounds to get in? Because our coefficient's poor or whatever. It's rubbish. It's rubbish. It's a system designed to keep the small guy out. And it's just this whole mindset that's how it is. You're getting nothing. Well, see, tonight we put two fingers up to that establishment, certainly with the football establishment, and said, I don't think so. And we'll do it again. I really believe that. You know, that's my next point, is that after tonight, Brendan Rodgers has brought something back to Celtic Park. I said that in a few episodes ago, that he's got his finger on the pulse. He has his finger on the pulse. He most definitely has his finger on the pulse. He's a Celtic man, and he knows what it means. And I'm telling you, he's sitting in front of those players and he's saying to them, this is what it means to play for this club. And he'll be using the Lisbon Lions, he'll be using Jock Stein, he'll be using the great sides that we've had, you know, Tommy Burns and all these other guys that you know, Martin O'Neill and even Neil Lennon to an extent, guys who have got the club on their heart. And say to the players, if you're here as a glory hunter, if you're here to use this club just as a stepping stone, if you're here because you think it's easy to win games in Scotland, or if you're here just because, you know, you want to like have a few games in Europe, and then move along, because you're here to play for the club. Now, it's fine, we understand guys like Virgil van Dijk and, you know, Fraser Forster will come and go. We don't expect to hang on to players for 6, 7, 8, 9 years. But at the same time, we don't want mercenaries. We don't want guys that are coming in for a year and then pissing off. Hello, Di Canio. I'm looking at you, although I still love Daniel, but I hate him. But, you know, Brendan Rodgers will speak to those players, and I have no doubts that he will have them fired up and under no illusions what it means to play for Celtic and to represent Glasgow and to represent Scotland. And that's what we did tonight, and we do it better than anybody else. We do it better than anybody else, and we always have. So, to all our media hacks, to guys like Roy Keane, who says we shouldn't celebrate getting into the Champions League, to guys like Tom English, who said we need counselling after the Barcelona game, to idiots at Clyde, to guys at the Daily Record, to some of the guys at the BBC, to all the media outlets who continually try and drag us down if we lose a game, or tell us that we're up against it, or we'll never make it. You know, and this goes pre-qualifying against Hapoel. You know, I've seen it again and again every year. The media comes out and goes, oh, it's a very difficult task for Celtic. No one supports us. No one says that we can do it. No one believes in us. I've got a message for all of you guys with your negative press. Keep doing it. Please keep doing it, because you know what it does? It just feeds us. The more you put us down, the more we pull ourselves up. And tonight is evidence of that. We come off a 7-0 tanking at Barca, and everyone thinks, oh, they're going to get spanked again. You get guys like Robbie Savage, sponsored by some betting company, saying that we're going to get tanked, and other guys, and all these English pundits. And I was listening to the English commentary at the beginning of it. There was two or three different channels covering it, and the English commentator was like, oh, I'm worried about Celtic. They're not going to keep this tempo up, and Man City are going to score, and blah, blah, blah. And as the game progressed, you could hear these guys, they were changing their commentary of the game. They were basically like, yeah, we better reel it in a bit, because Celtic are actually playing really good football and are making Man City look panicked, you know, like no one's seen this season. So to all you guys, go ahead, keep trying to drag us down. We don't care. Like I said in that other podcast, we don't give a expletive. Keep doing it. We don't need your press. We don't need any of you, because we are Celtic family. We support each other. We support ourselves, and we do it because of our history, and we do it for the people who love the club, and we do it for those who are less fortunate and have, you know, less than others. You know, and that's the spirit of the club. We stand and fight for each other, and tonight every single one of those players deserves, and Matt, as far as I'm concerned, all the praise that they can get. And that's just for a draw. That's just for a 3-3 draw. So maybe guys like Roy Keane might not like that. We shouldn't celebrate a draw, probably. We certainly shouldn't celebrate being in the group where we are now. That's not worth celebrating, is it, Roy? We should be celebrating a draw either. We should only celebrate if we win. I tell you, I'd love to be at a party at Roy Keane's house. It must be a fun time. Reminds me of that guy at Father Ted. I don't know if you have any of you have watched Father Ted. There's one father, one of the priests that just sits about with the long face, and no one can make him smile. That's Mr. Roy Keane. Don't celebrate getting into the Champions League. Don't do it. You know, it's guys like that, and all these other detractors and naysayers. That just, they don't understand. They either don't spend time at the club, or they don't spend time at Scottish football, or they're so busy covering other games or other leagues or EPL, and they don't get it. They just don't get it, and that's fine, because I don't actually care about them. I don't even know why I'm giving them that much time, because it actually doesn't bother me that much. I'm more interested in what you guys think. I'm more interested in the social media that we create, because that's the real social media, you know, the underground social media is the real media. Now, a lot of it is Celtic fans, so obviously it's complimentary, but we're also brutally honest about ourselves when we fail. It's not as if we're not critical. We're very critical of ourselves sometimes, so much that there's a lot of infighting, and it's the same with other clubs. It's the same with Sevco. They're the same as well. They tear each other apart when things are going bad, which is what's happening to them now, because they're in a mess, because they're unrealistic, and they can't build up slowly with humility. They've got to be the best straight away all the time, and you know, they'll put themselves into millions and millions and millions of pounds of debt just to be that way. But that all comes from pressure, you know, and that's inward pressure. And so when you want insight or you want opinions, sometimes you're better to avoid the mainstream media because all they're going to do is they're just going to feed you nonsense. But it's worth, you know, I look at all media outlets and I look at all the punditry that goes on and stuff, and I do enjoy some of the stuff, but it's just sometimes when you hear some of the stuff coming out from these guys, you just think, oh, man, I hope we just spank someone at Parkhead and give them a real surprise. We nearly beat them tonight, so well done, Celtic. Well done. Thank you. You put a real smile on my face. It's been a bit of a tough couple of weeks for me, but I tell you what, man, when I watch Celtic play like that, it just the sun comes out no matter what the weather is, you know, so well done. Well done, everybody. All the Celtic players, you deserve everything that you get. I'm sorry about the background noise, guys. I'm recording this during the day, and there's a lot of stuff going on in the background. So hopefully the quality of this isn't too bad. I'm not going to do much editing. I just wanted to do a quick podcast after the game, and it was interesting watching the formation. I did think that was going to be the lineup. I didn't get any surprises. You know, Lustig on the right, Eric and Toure in the middle, Tierney on the left, and then Brown and Bitton sitting in front of them with Rogic just in front in the midfield, and then Dembele with Forrest and Sinclair. I mean, that's what everybody thought was going to line up. And right from the off, it's funny because before the game, I thought, you know, Brendan Rodgers really, his strengths are pressing and pushing, and that game where we put teams under pressure and use pace and speed and hit it up the wings when we can, you know, when we get the ball, if teams do press us back on a slight counter when we've got the ball, move it quickly and push teams back. And I thought, you know, when we played against Barca, he was a bit more tentative. It was like the team didn't really know what to do. And I don't think, I still think our team has to develop defensively. I think our best defence is our offence at the moment. I don't think we really know how to play that defensive game. And I think when we learn how to play a more strong defensive game, that we'll get even better, which is quite scary because, you know, everybody knows we're leaking goals, but we're scoring goals as well, and it makes for such entertaining games. You know, when you talk about playing the Celtic way, that's pretty much what's happening at the moment, you know. But we do need to just tighten up the defence, and I still believe that you'll see us maybe set up differently maybe next season in Europe or down the line when we start to get a better grip on how we play defensively. But certainly Brendan Rodgers has shown that that's how he wants to play. And I was thinking to myself before the game, and I saw a lot of people on social media say this as well, just go and play the game. We're at home, take it to them. Now when we play away, we seem to be a different side. It's the same old story with us, you know. We're always more dangerous at home. We haven't been in the past few seasons because there was a mental weakness. There was no spirit. And that's back, and that's the most single important thing for me, is that there's fight and belief in the team. It's just so apparent. And I was so glad to see us bring that more offensive style and pressure and style to City. And I believe that that's what's going to happen quite a bit, certainly at home. And I believe that we can get a result. I believe that we can get better results at home. I believe that we'll do much better against Barca. It might even be a similar kind of game against Barca. Maybe a high scoring draw. I believe we can beat Mönchengladbach at home. And I believe that we might even be able to beat them away as well, which would be incredible, or at least a draw. So, it's all to play for. I think Barcelona are going to take points off Man City. And Man City have already beaten Gladbach, so, you know, it's all to play for. All to play for, guys. Anything's possible. And like I said in the previous episode, there's no pressure on us. We're already here. We made it. We're in the group stages, and we're celebrating being in the group stages because it's a big deal for us. It's a big deal for us. And anybody who says we shouldn't celebrate for getting into the group stages, you don't have a clue about Celtic, and you don't have a clue about the club. Keep those opinions to yourself, because if you make them, I guarantee you, most of the Celtic support will just shoot you down. We know what it means to this club. It's massive for us. It's massive mainly because of the hurdles that have been put in front of us. And it's our way of saying to them, it doesn't matter how much you try and stop us getting in, we're here. And that's why we celebrate. If you don't understand the psychology and the mentality of Celtic, the Celtic support, then don't claim to be associated with the club or know anything about the club. Sorry, but people annoy me, so I have to get it off my chest. I didn't want to rant after this. I actually had planned an episode where I was going to bring in. I've still got someone lined up to come on the podcast. I got two people lined up to come on the podcast. So it's just getting time to do that. It's very difficult. I've got to do it at my lunchtime, and I've got a very busy setup here at home. We have a business that we run from home, so I've literally got to run up at lunchtime, get everything set up, and do a kind of Skype call with somebody, and I haven't been able to do that yet just because of personal reasons on both sides, but will come anyway. I didn't plan to sit here and rant about the game. I don't have any notes. I've just you know, I've watched the game and I'm just talking to you all because I've got no one to talk to. It's just me and my Todd here, so I'm talking to you and just want to say I'm so proud to be a Celtic supporter. I'm so proud of the way you all acted tonight in the stadium. It was incredible watching that. It was incredible. Really, you showed the world what it means to have passion and spirit and belief and to have a love of your club and just to have a love of your fellow support. So, yeah, amazing Celtic. Amazing. Just every single time you blow me away. You really do. Fantastic. So, yeah. What a game. And great formation, great tactics from Brendan, brilliant performances. Bittern was good. He really was. He dug in. And it's like I said before about Bittern, when he digs in, oh man, he can be brilliant. And he did it tonight. Toure, oh man, that guy is just a monster in defence. He just... Colo Toure is brilliant, man. He's a rock. Eric Sviatchenko was great as well. He made an amazing... last ditch tackle when I think it was Nolito or Aguero was coming through. Oh, man, what a tackle he made. Everybody was fighting for the ball, they really were. Just all over the park, you know, and Sinclair was harrying at the front, and just everybody was just at the belly fight. I mean, it's like Brendan said, we defend from the front, you know, we've got to defend from the front, and it's just excellent to see that style of football being implemented effectively, you know, at the very highest level. If you think that this is a team that Brendan Rodgers has recently just put together, what's it going to be like next season? You know, we've not spent a huge amount of money. He's using most of the team that Ronnie Dyla had, which has been pointed out on a couple of other podcasts I listened to recently. And it's just incredible to think that if we keep progressing and investing and better players, and just it's just going to get better and better. So it's like I said in the previous episode, this is a golden time for us. It really is. I lived through the Rangers 10 in a row. I watched us get hammered every other season, not hammered on the park kind of thing, but you know, just in terms of being Celtic supporters and living underneath the charade of Rangers and their financial cheating and that whole, you know, kind of oppressive feeling of growing up in Glasgow and being treated like a second tier person for being a Celtic supporter and everything that went with it, and we're miles from that now, miles and miles from that now. We've risen above that, and it's nights like tonight or mornings like this morning, if you're a New Zealander or even in Australia or wherever you are in the world, times like this that just lift you up again. They really do. So, yep. I keep fading in and out of analysing the game because I'm getting carried away talking about it. But brilliant game, brilliant goals, amazing goals. I mean, Kieran Tierney's goal was fantastic. Dembele's overhead kick was just... he just took it so well. It was just... his technique was... Because he almost put a little bit... it wasn't like straight. He kind of angled it a bit. It's almost like he knew the keeper was at a certain spot and he went, I'll just kind of angle it. The guy's brilliant, man. Honestly, such great technique. And City scored some excellent goals as well, you know. I did think that one of the goals that went in, I think it was the third goal they scored, we were ball watching by quite a few defenders in the boxes. We defended really well. We were doing really well packing out the defence in the midfield. But I think that for the third goal, the equaliser, the third equaliser, we were kind of ball watching a wee bit and not picking up a runner. But it's not a criticism, it's just ball watching is something that we need to be careful of. That it's just concentration, but that game is played at a very high tempo and you get tired legs and it can affect your thinking and your movement and stuff a bit. So it's not a criticism, but excellent game, excellent goals. What a night. If you were at Parkhead, I'm jealous. I'm really jealous, but I love you all. You're all fantastic. You make me proud. You really do. I know I keep going on and I know I'm getting a bit emotional, but it's been a long time since I've been at Parkhead on a European night, and I'm very far from home. So when I see games like that, it gets me. It gets me. It does. It gets you. It brings all the emotion out in you. It makes you so proud. I felt like running up the street with my Celtic top on, but no one would know what I was doing because they all watch rugby or they all watch the EPL. So it's great, guys, it's great. Nights, just times like that, I love it. What a time to be alive, what a time to be a Tim. Look, I think I'll end it there. It's a strange wee episode, this one, but I just wanted to jump on the pod and say well done to the players, well done to the support, well done to everybody who's supporting the club through social media, through their podcasts, and just let's all keep it going. There's a real positivity around the club. Let's all support each other. Support all the guys on social media and everybody who's involved in helping others, the Kano Foundation, all the charities and everything that's positive around the club. Let's build on that and let's move away from all the rubbish and all the negative stuff. Let's lift ourselves away from that because that's not what we're about. Let's be an example to others, and because that's who we are. That's who we are. We've got big hearts and we're brilliant people. The Glaswegians are brilliant, the Scots are brilliant, and Celtic support are brilliant, and that means Celtic support from all over the world. It's like I said, I was speaking to somebody recently, and they said, you know, you don't find the club finds you, and that is about who you are, not where you're from. All right, guys, whew, it's been an emotional episode. Thank you for listening to me rambling on, but I had to get it off my chest. Next episode, we'll cover the usual bits and pieces and try and get someone on and go through a few things. I've no idea who we're playing next because I haven't had time to look at anything. I've been too busy. But safe to say, I think we're in good hands for the next few games. So have a great night and enjoy yourselves wherever you are, guys. Hail, hail. Take care.